Hi, Fanula. And of course, one of the big things that we've been talking about with the Deputy Foreign Minister, Faisal al-Maqdad, was the recent gains that the opposition says that it's making, especially in northern Syria, of course, taking a very strategic hydroelectric power dam, as well as also taking a very big military base. Now, I confronted the Deputy Foreign Minister with that, and he said he still believes that the Syrian military is the one that's in the driver's seat. Let's listen into what he had to say.
I think we are winning. We have already won. You are in Damascus. You are aware of what's happening around Damascus. They threatened to have Damascus, more than 1 year ago, and they are not there. We are still here.
How do you see this evolving in the future?
What we want to do is to solve the issue on peaceful basis. Something which President Assad has said from the beginning of
the
year.
But is it really possible to solve this issue on peaceful basis when your army is shelling neighborhoods? I mean, using artillery to hit urban neighborhoods.
This is a reaction. You cannot imagine the damage and destruction and the killing and the crimes committed by these people against civilians.
What could a peaceful solution look like, and where could negotiations start? Because that seems to be one of the biggest problems at the moment.
We hope that those who are willing to stop the destruction of Syria come to the national dialogue without conditions to sit together as Syrians under Syrian leadership and sort out our problems together.
And of course, Fanula, that the meeting that is going to happen in Moscow, of course, the foreign minister of Syria and the leader of the opposition both coming there. It's not a face-to-face meeting, but both of them coming there for talks. That might be a small first step, but it still seems to be the big problem what terms peace talks could happen in. The Syrian government, of course, saying they want talks to happen in Damascus. They want the opposition to come here, whereas the opposition says they want these talks to happen in northern Syria, perhaps, or outside the country. So right now, both sides still very much at loggerheads. Both sides also claiming that they're making significant gains on the battlefield as well, and that therefore they are the ones who can set the terms as to where these negotiations and how these negotiations take place. So still a lot dividing these sides, obviously, and the conflict getting worse, if anything, rather than better. Nevertheless, those meetings that happen in Moscow could be a small first step to these two sides trying to get to the table.
And a lot of attention will be focused on that. Thanks very much, Fred Pleitgen in Damascus.